All right, I want to welcome everyone to our third town hall meeting for Cleveland County Schools. Right now, I do not have anyone signed up to speak. Is there anyone that wants to speak tonight and address the group? You don't have to. You're welcome to. That's up to you guys. Okay, anyone else besides Mr. Williams? What we'll do, following our previous formats in our other town hall meetings, I'm not going to go through all the particular guidelines. I know Mr. Williams has been at the other two, he knows what those are. We'll have 4 minutes to speak, and then after Mr. Williams, if there's anyone else who'd like to speak, just raise your hand. We'll go about that. Is that fair, fair, right? Sound good? Okay, Mr. Williams?
Folks, my name is Robert Williams. I'm from Austin. I didn't intend to speak tonight, but I've been doing some research and some things I think that folks that are involved in issues in schools probably need to know about. We have an election in just a few weeks. I think the early voting starts in just a couple days. There's been a lot of news, a lot of debates. I think there's a debate tonight between Kay Hagan and Tom Tillis. And Kay Hagan has accused Tom Tillis of cutting funds for education. So when I hear things like that, I decide I want to look it up just to find out what's going on. And what I found out was that certain funds for education have been cut. But there's three components that I can tell. There's grants and other things that produce revenue for schools. But typically, you have the state that provides the majority of the funding. The local folks that provide a lot less, and then the federal government provides a certain percentage too. And what has happened since Tom Tillis has been Speaker of the House is every year the state component is increased by hundreds of millions of dollars. The same and Tom Tillis is running for U.S. Senate. Kay Hagan is running for U.S. Senate, and she has been our senator for the last 6 years. The federal component of the funding for education has gone down. So Kay Hagan is a federal official. The funding for schools in North Carolina has gone down under her watch. I think people ought to be aware of her. Now, I also say this, the funding from the county has gone down too. The county, in Cleveland County, I'm talking about, I think over the overall state, most of the school systems have increased from student population. Cleveland County has gone down, and the county has lowered their funding too. So the federal government has decreased the funding for education. Our local county commissioner in Cleveland County has lowered the funding for education, and the state has increased. So that's and maybe some of the school board members might want to say something about this too. But from my research, if you're interested in education, you're seeing their fair share of the funding at the state level, you vote for Tom Tillis. And this is the way politics works. If you're interested in education and you don't think we're funded adequately, you can look at the people that have provided increases school education in Madison. Kay Hagan has none. County commissioners have none. The state has increased. And it's a record. It's a record for the North Carolina Department of Public Instruction. So, anyway, my recommendation is anybody who's interested in funding. funding for education. We go out and vote election day, November the 4th, or early voting, whatever you want to do, and you vote for Tom Pickens. So I turn this into a little political thing, but it's weird.
Thank you. I have to apologize. I have to recognize that we do have two board members here tonight, Mr. Roger Harris and Danny White. I did receive comment from one of the board members that said, yes, sir.
Thank you.
nothing else, our next town meeting will be in Walnut Springs at the Masonic Lodge. I think that's November 11th at 7 p.m. So that'll close out getting the four zones done. So going once, going twice if you'd like to speak. Okay, well, I appreciate everyone coming.